Bermain Dupri net worth. 5 fast facts you need to know. Bermain Dupri is one of the hottest men in the music industry these days, and given that he's worked with and produced for stars like Mariah Carey, Jay-Z, Nelly, Janet Jackson, Aretha Franklin, Alicia Keys, and the Ludacris, among others, it isn't a surprise that people are curious about the amount of money he makes. What is Dupri's net worth? How much money does he make? Read on to find out. 1. He has an estimated net worth of $2 million. Dupri has an estimated net worth of $2 million, according to Celebrity Net Worth. The hip-hop artist has won a number of awards as proof of his success over the years, including a Grammy Award for Best R&B Song in 2006 for We Belong Together, the NAACP Image Award for Outstanding Album in 1998 for Soul Food, and a Soul Train Music Award. Quincy Jones Award for Career Achievement in 2007. In an interview with Under30.com, Dupri spoke about his entrepreneurial spirit, which he developed as a young boy. When I was around 11 or 12, I used to go around the neighborhood to cut people's grass and go house to house to cut the deal with them. Dupri admits he didn't have the financial means of paving his success. People always talk about the money they need to do it. I was always the guy who said I was going to do it. The artist continues, my gradual gain of things that I needed to get to the places I was headed to came from my ambition and my attitude to do it. 2. His father was a Columbia Records executive. Dupri was born in 1972 to Tina Mosley and Michael Malton. Malton's career began in the 1970s, and eventually, he made a name for himself as the president of Columbia Records, former senior vice president of Columbia Records Group, the manager, and the CEO of Scream Nation. During his term at Columbia, Malton was heavily involved in the budding careers of stars like Destiny's Child, Alicia Keys, Wyclef Jean, and N.A.S. In an interview with Artists House Music in 2010, Malton said there were pros and cons to being his son's father and manager. We didn't have a lot, but I was always around for Bermain, Malton said. It was an interesting dynamic, but I always had his back. I was always looking out, and I think that was cool for him to know that somebody is always there making sure that he was, you know, taken care of. 3. His first act was the hip-hop trio Silk Times Leather. In 1990, Dupri produced his first act, a female hip-hop trio called Silk Times Leather. 1 year later, he put together the teen group Criss Cross. The band, which consisted of Chris Kelly and Chris Smith, released their first album, Totally Crossed Out, in 1992, and it went multi-platinum. Shortly after establishing these two groups, Dupri founded So So Def Recordings. It wasn't long after that he was introduced to the female R&B group Xscape and signed them to the new label. 4. He reportedly lost his Atlanta home to foreclosure. Dupri reportedly lost his Atlanta mansion in 2014 to foreclosure. According to Fulton County legal documents obtained by the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, the producer and songwriter owed $2.5 million on his over 9,400 square foot home, but did not pay his monthly payments, which led to a mortgage foreclosure notice. According to the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, the legal notice read, "The debt secured by said deed to secure debt has been and is hereby declared due because of, among other possible events of default, non-payment of the monthly installments on said loan. The debt remaining in default, this sale will be made for the purpose of paying the same and all expenses of this sale, including attorney's fees. Notice of intent to collect attorney's fees having been given." The home was 6 bedrooms, sat on 1.73 acres, and was over 9,441 square feet. The Daily Mail reports that Dupri purchased it in 2005 for $3.2 million. 5. He is the founder of Global 14 and So So Def Recordings. An entrepreneur at heart, Dupri is the founder of Global 14 and So So Def Recordings. The latter has released more than 25 albums, with many gold, platinum, and double platinum records. Asked by Under30.co if he's always been entrepreneurial, the artist says, "I've always thought that I could create some kind of business. I've always had the feeling." In May of 2013, SunTrust Banks sued Dupri and So So Def Productions for $1.9 million for defaulting on a $5 million loan, according to Billboard.com. Dupri countered with another lawsuit. According to TMZ, Dupree claimed that a personal banker took advantage of his lack of education by having him sign an additional loan agreement that increased his loan payments without his knowledge. Despite the suit, the company has continued to find success. It currently reps VA Brat, Bow Wow, Jaquan, Jagged Edge, Dem Franchise Boys, and Xscape. In 2014, So Def partnered with Primary Wave to release Jagged Edge's album J.E. Heartbreak 2. Last year, it partnered with Epic for current distribution.